What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today I want to show you a deal that lets you have your own changelog, roadmap, and feedback system. Super easy to integrate on your website or use it as a standalone site. Now, I'm going to show you what the deal is about and how to actually use it. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. Okay, guys, so the deal that I'm talking about is called Sleekplan. It's, like I said before, a roadmap, changelog, and a feedback system all in one. Now, it's super easy to integrate. Let me show you what the deal's about. It starts off at $59 for a lifetime deal. And if you guys want to grab the deal and you feel that these videos help you out, do consider using that link in the description. Now, let me show you what that deal actually gets you. Well, you get unlimited tracked users, unlimited feedback items, unlimited suggestions, unlimited subscribers. That subscribers is really neat because when people view the change log and they subscribe to the system, well, you send them alerts when something new happens, all right? So the first plan, that's $59, gets you 10,000 page views, 5 teammates, 1 company workspace. That means one site or one system, okay? One custom domain, and you can remove the branding on Sleekplan. My personal recommendation is if you're going to use Sleekplan, I recommend you jump into license tier 2 because it gives you unlimited page views. This is really important because you know you won't be capped if you have a lot of page views. You get 2 workspaces on this one and 2 custom domains. So that means you can have 2 separate companies. In those 2 separate companies, you can have your changelog, your feedback, and the roadmap on it, on each one of the workspaces. And license tier 3, well, it's basically license tier 2, but with 5 companies. I wish they had a plan with unlimited domains, but they don't. They go up to 5 company workspaces. Okay, what is Sleekplan? This is the dashboard, but let me show you really quickly how it actually looks on a website. This is just a demo website. Obviously, you don't see anything fancy here, but on the left, I integrated the feedback option right here. So if I open it, we're able to view changelog, roadmap, and they can leave a feedback. We can turn on or turn off any one of these 3 features because maybe you don't want to use something, because maybe you don't have a changelog because this is not about a SaaS. Well, you keep the other options like the updates, information, and the changelog or the roadmap. Check this out. I could open it, go to roadmap, go back, go to changelog, and you can have these super easy to integrate and you can leave a feedback really quickly. Now, like I mentioned before, this is super easy to integrate. If you're on WordPress site, just put it in the header, right? Just put a special piece of code that they provide and you're good to go. If you have a hard time installing it on WordPress site, for example, just install a plugin that's header and footer and just insert the code in the header. Super easy. Okay, so main panel, what you're gonna see is the overview of the analytics. Tracks users, emails delivered, and page views. We got the page views by 30 days. What are the pages they are viewing? The feedback that's been happening. These are all my tests right here. So feedback for 3 posts, the votes, the comments, and completed. You got the customer satisfaction score. So all positive on that side. The change log, no subscribers for them right now. High impact, upcoming, and the community feed. So what's been going on over here? Now, let's go into settings. In settings, like I mentioned before, we can enable or disable any one of the features. So for example, if we don't need the feedback module, we can turn it off, or the changelog, or the roadmap, or the satisfaction module. Turn on or off any one of those. And we have all the settings for these to customize it, to have our own colors, to have the settings that we want to leave on or off. For example, notify upvoters, can they downvote or not? Is there going to be moderation? For example, if you don't moderate it, someone can add a feedback and they don't need permission. So I would turn this on if I were you. Default sort by, default category, just basically all the options for the settings over there. Plus we have the team members that's obviously on the plan that you're on. So for example, tier 1, 5 team members, tier 2, unlimited, and tier 3, unlimited team members that you can add, okay? Next option we have is the widget website. Like I said before, it's a special little code right here that we can grab it, paste it over there. You're good to go. I also created this test CNAME custom domain plan just so you can see it, which is this one, all right? This one right here, right? So this is a standalone website. If I send someone this link, they get to open it. You don't actually have to have a specific website to add the widget. You can actually do it this way. Just give them the link. And you got the changelog, and the roadmap, right? Just like that, without even having to have a website. So you can use that one and you're good to go. We got the standalone page right here. The settings for the one we just saw. Are we going to enable Kanban roadmap, the page colors, and if we want to add some special code right here, we can add some footer links also. All right, let's go back to widgets and website. You have the appearance content. So this is where we're going to edit the widget that's actual on the website, the one that we embedded. So remember, we saw this blue one right here. What is the default language? Well, it's English, but there's this language is available. So not many languages available right now. If you need any specific language, I guess we have to ask for it. In my case, I'm lucky Spanish is there in case I want to use it on a Spanish site. We have the content information, like we want to customize this instead of saying hi there. It's like, hey, SAS Masters, something like that. Widget description, basically it's all the settings right here. And yes, we can remove the branding from Sleekplan. The pop-ups, we want to enable the pop-ups right here if we want to use those. If you want to enable feedback, satisfaction, subscribe, or announcement, we can enable those or disable. Statuses, this is where we add the statuses, for example, for the roadmap, because maybe you're not just going to use, for example, open, closed, or completed. I added a personal one, which would be working on now. So that's pretty common that we see on a SaaS. So they let users know when something is actually, when they're working on it right now, because it lets you know that, hey, that's coming really near and soon. And we can enable or disable any one of these. So if we don't want to use closed, we can disable it because these are the three default ones. And we can add more statuses if we need. Also categories, we can add more if we need, depending on what we need it for. It's obvious that we're going to add our own categories right here. We got developer. This is really cool. You get access to API. So basically you can do a whole bunch of things with Sleekplan. For the webhook, one of the things I wish they add is that they had incoming webhooks. Right now they only have outgoing webhooks. What am I talking about? Well, what I'm saying is that when I add something on Sleekplan, it's gonna send out the webhook with the information, which is pretty cool because with a webhook, you can go send out an email, you can add a social media post, you can do a whole bunch of stuff with it, but it doesn't have incoming webhooks. Why would I need this? Let's just say I'm using Zapier, Public Connect, Integrately, any one of those. And maybe when I make a social media post, it'll automatically create also an update on Sleekplan. That would be a use case. Now, one of the positive sides is that Zapier does have incoming, all right? So no webhook for incoming, but Zapier does have it. So for example, if I were to use Zapier, I have the option to create a feedback, update a feedback, or create a changelog update. So in this case, I do have a way to send incoming information. On the webhook, that's not available. I hope they add that soon. I hope they see this video and take that into consideration because that's something that could be pretty useful for most of us. Integrations, so integrates with Chrome. There's a Chrome extensions, Cloudflare, GitHub, Intercom, Shopify, WordPress. Here's Zapier. You have to jump from here to actually use Zapier because you won't find it if you don't add it through here because it's in beta stage, right? Then we have the subscription. So that's what I have right now, the plan that I'm using for this testing video. Now, the good part, how do we actually post these things on there? All right, so remember we got the changelog, we got the roadmap. So how do we work that? Let's go into feedback. We have the feedbacks that are assigned and we have the new post, all right? So in this case, I'll just say testing for video, and we'll describe it, testing. We'll drop an image right here. We'll just grab any screenshot that I have there. And let's go ahead and put it in update or feature. We'll just say it's an update. Let's submit it. Okay, now we just posted it. Let's go ahead and approve it because we added the moderation. Let's go into our site. Let's refresh it. Okay, let's check out the feedback and video for Sleekplan. Let me go to sort by newest. All right, testing for video. Here it is. We can upvote. We can downvote. Pretty weird how I jumped from 2 to 0. It should jump to 1. Heads up there, all right? Okay, let's go back into Sleekplan. Now, roadmap. Here is the roadmap. You can see these, right? Obviously, we can drag and drop these. So for example, right now it's open, testing for video. I'm making it right now. So we're working on it, jump it there. Welcome post, let's just say that's closed. and we'll leave the other ones just like that. So let's go back into our widget, refresh, open, roadmap, and here it is. We just sent the welcome post to closed. And what else did we move? Testing for video, working on right now. Something I wish that Sleekplan had is that if we click away, it would close the widget. I hate to go to the little X to go and close it. I mean, that's just a little thing that I wish they had. Just click off and it's gone. The changelog, we can add a new changelog right here. New update, we'll just say new for video. Again, just testing. We link to a test. Let's put our site, sasmaster.net. And link and blog, nah, we'll leave that. Link color, we'll say blue. Okay, blue. Category, this is gonna be into feature. Notify subscribers, maybe you don't want to be too annoying, so maybe that's not a big announcement. If it was, maybe you do want to notify them, so you have that option. Notification queue, in-app announcements, and date and time that you wanna drop, and drop an image. We can go ahead and publish this. And just like that, you added something to the changelog. So like I said, super easy to integrate and super easy to use once you have it all set up. Next thing we have is the satisfaction, which is the feedback that you're gonna get from users. And you're gonna see the data right here. So for example, here's a message that I sent. I said, great tool. Sentiment right now is 100%. So everything is fine. Historical performance and data records is all right there. Super easy to do. Let me show you how that works. Let's go ahead and open this on an incognito tab. All right, there we go. Go to feedback. Let's just say I'm neutral. All right, so we have that neutral there. We have the option to enable them to actually have to register or they can skip it. For now, I have it disabled and they could just skip it. They don't have to put the email, but you can have that to make it, like make them actually do it, all right? And we can add something right here like, I wish the site was faster, right? Just as an example there, let's submit it and boom, that's sent out. Now we have that information over here on Sleekplan. Oop, over here, let's refresh it. Okay, now we have one neutral right there and you can see that little gauge turned a little bit because now it's in between super happy and neutral. So it's a 75% data. So basically that is how Sleekplan works. If you're looking for something like this, that's easy to integrate, easy to use, and have the options for the integrations, like I mentioned before, with webhooks and Zapier, this is a really good option because some of the other systems that you might not have that system. So easy to use. If you want to use it, integrate the widget into a site, or if you want to use it as a standalone. In terms of prices, I think the system is pretty good for the price. I just wish they gave a little bit more companies, right? So in my personal perspective, I think tier one at least should be 3 companies, 5, and at least 15 for license tier 3. But that's just my suggestion. Maybe the system is too good and that's the right price for them. Well, that is the deal with Sleekplan. Let me know what you guys are actually using or what you think about this deal, if it's worth getting or not. Well, like I said before, if you guys would like to support me and if you find this video helpful, do consider using that link in the description. It helps me out with a small commission and it won't cost you a single cent more. So thank you for watching. My name is George. This is SaaS Master and I'll see you guys later.